bit of early morning crawling here on the course. Kind of check things out. Do a little start over here. Just see, do a little more practice on this here. Just kind of BS while we do this. So, this little guy here is going to be getting a companion here soon. I bought a truck version that I'm getting ready to start on this winter. And then I'll be able to have two of these little guys running around. I really enjoy the one that I have here. And, you know, need more practice. Here and just, you know, see how well we can do here. I haven't ran this course very much, so I'm still pretty new to it, but it is a decent little course for these. I really feel like it handles the course well, and I feel like it's a decent challenge for it, so I haven't really wanted to do much to the course. That's what you see here. Kind of got a little jungle-ish type theme, I guess you would say. I just figured it looked cool. So now, there's two different ways you can go. You can go up the ramp and go around that way and down. I like to go through there. It seems like, at least in the beginning, it's a little more of a challenge because all these rocks and stuff in the way. It's a really tight turn right there too, so what you can't see is inside of here. I don't really have a way to get the camera in there, but it's kind of stuck back in there, and it's going to be popping out over here on this ramp. So I'll show you right here in just a minute. There we go. I'm starting to come up the ramp now. So down there, it's all pretty dark. Even if I put the phone down there, I can't really get the angles because it's so tight in here. It's kind of hard to get in there and show you what's going on. I will eventually come up with something because I do have some smaller cameras. I just got to figure out some mounting and stuff for it. Haven't really gotten that far with this yet. Okay, again, there's two ways. You can go up here, which is the easier way, or you can go around. I always have trouble going around, so I think I'm going to try that one today. Kind of see what I can do. Because I generally kind of flip the truck when I try to get too crazy with it. So the trick is to get your ass around. Which, as you can see, there's not a lot of room to work with here, so it's quite a challenge. If you can get that right tire to hook up on it without being stuck like that, it's good. I'm probably going to have to come over here just to get back where I need to. Okay, now we got the tire on. So what I'm going to try to do is come around here, I'll show you, come up at the edge as much as possible where I can get my ass around. And once I get that to come around, I'm pretty much golden. That's usually where the trick's at. You have an angle, it's pretty cheap right there for it. You just got to be careful coming around the corner. Try not to get hung up on too much of the rocks. Which again, that's part of the challenge. But but it could definitely be difficult, that's for sure. Okay. Put him back up here. I didn't want him to fall on the ground there and bust in pieces. But I used the rocks to walk him around. I'm trying to do this as I talk and stuff. Usually I would be like right there where I could see it. Because, like I said, it's a bit of a challenge here. So, it's kind of difficult for me to talk and stuff at the same time. I don't do well with that. But if you keep working this, usually you can get up. Gotta find the right catch. Sometimes you gotta bump it. Like that. That is really hung up bad, somewhere over here. Okay, so we'll start it out again here. So what I'm gonna do, instead of going through the tunnel here at the beginning, I'm gonna come through and up and over and around and down, and then I'll finish out that way. So kind of shift this truck a little bit. Fall off the course. Yeah, these little Orlandoos, man, they got some decent flex on them. At least the one that I built. I don't know if that's all of them, but they seem to be pretty decent little capable machines, so I'm actually very happy with mine. This section here is really kind of a pain sometimes. If you don't hit it right, it doesn't let you walk up. You can kind of hit this wide, but you gotta watch out for the rock here and the bridge. So, stay away from the bridge, and I'll go as wide as we can. That's probably about it right here, because now we're in the bridge. And then up here at the top, you gotta really stay up in this corner, because it will flip. Back up, it's gotta be easy, and use this corner here to turn yourself around without falling off. Like that. Okay, so we're just gonna restart right here. We'll use this as my hand of God or whatever. So what I'm going to try to do is, it's really difficult here in this corner, and it's kind of on design, so I'm going to try to swing around a little bit if I can. It's kind of difficult to do it, but if you can get your ass to swing around, see how it likes to slide on the rock there. I mean, I didn't build this course to be easy, but you know, some of these things are pretty difficult. I wish I'd have been a little bit easier on them. think I might have an axe. So we're barely on the bridge. I don't want to come off any more than what we are. Okay, so we want to come down this ramp. Got to kind of be easy. See how it wants to slide. Now the easiest way is to pull up and then back down it. But I'm going to try to get it turned around if I can. It's pretty difficult. But once you get it, you know you got it. Because you can use the ramps to kind of like turn you a little bit. Get it going, it'll kind of help you out. Like right here, I can just wiggle a little bit and get some room. Now I'm actually getting in there. Okay, so I got myself turned around. Somewhat lined up on the ramp. And I come down. This is the part that I really can't show you because it's kind of like, there's not really, even if I can get the camera down here, I can't get it behind here to show you what I'm doing. I do have some smaller cameras, so I'm working on that. I'm going to try to put something in there to where I can kind of show you what I'm talking about in there. But you can see it if you're sitting out here playing with it. Basically, to just go in, over, and out. It's a pretty basic setup, but for these little trucks, you know, it's a great little challenge. There you go. So that's my little Orlandoo Hunter course and the truck. It's a little bit of a challenge for this guy, especially coming up over here. I tried it several times and I just wasn't able to get it. Sometimes I can, sometimes I can't, but these rocks here typically hang it up on the axles in the back right here. This little pumpkin or whatever. You have to hit that just right. I considered maybe taking some of that down, but I really like the challenge of that, so I think I'm going to leave it. I thought about doing some more work to the course as well. I don't know, what do you guys think? I think it's pretty good. Even over here, if I start, I can come through here, but as you can see, it gets really narrow right there, so you got to be really careful coming through here, because there's barely enough room for the truck to fit. Trying to do this one-handed, guys. Yeah, it just barely fits. It's already off the course right there. So. But then when you come over here, it's much easier than hitting the bridge because you just come straight up. Well, unless you're talking like I am and you're just messing up anyway. For some reason, I can't chew gum and walk at the same time, I guess. There we go. See how it walks it over, and then you get your angle over a lot easier. You only have to make one backup, and then it's already lined up without flipping. But, it's a nice little course for these little trucks. I think this course actually turned out a lot better than the 24 course. I have more obstacles, I have more challenges, and it seems like everything works really well. I can hang it up on my wall, kind of get it out of the way, so that's a big plus as well. The colors turned out nice. I would like to have, like, eventually I wanted to put like some greenery backdrops, and I left a space in the back there. If I want to do a modular section, I can do another section and kind of add on, which I thought about doing. Eventually, I'd like to see what I could do with a hill climb on these, but I got to figure out, for one, if you look in the front, see how the steering bar or whatever hits the control arm and stuff for the servo, and it's not getting the full travel of the with the shock, which it does really well anyway, so I guess it doesn't matter. But I would like to get that gnawed out a little bit better, because the weight is more distributed towards the back on this guy, and it's, as you can see, it's really hard to to get the weight up front. So I'm thinking about buying some weights, putting them in the front, or maybe I'll just put some weights under the hood there or something. I gotta do something to try to get that down. Because right now it's just too heavy in the back. But I do wanna do an eventual hill climb with like some, I don't know, some loose dirt or something. Obviously that might not work for an indoor course, but that'd be cool to do outdoor for sure. Indoor, if I do the modular section there, I can still do the hill climb and I can mimic loose dirt by doing this spray foam, and I can make it smooth, rough it up just a little bit, and then when I rough it up, it'll be enough to where when a tire is hit, it kind of pulls some of the styrofoam off, and then it'll slide on the rest, so it gives it that imitation like it's dirt. So that might be pretty cool to do and make it kind of go up and up, and you know, make it kind of come up a little bit higher and you climb the mountain or something. I don't know, we'll figure something out on that. But so far this little course is great. This truck is great. It's a great little time passer. And as I said, you know, it's got plenty of obstacles in here for it, so it's pretty slick. I really enjoy it. I didn't expect it to turn out as good as it did, and it really did. It turned out awesome. I really enjoy it. So if you guys have any questions on this here, you want to build your own, you got any ideas, whatever, give me some comments down below, guys. I'll help you out, and I'll give you some ideas of, you know, what I have on my own, some pointers, some things that I learned not to do, that kind of stuff. So just let me know if you want to see stuff like that, or if you want me to just send you an email with how you need to do it, you got something going for your channel, whatever, let me know. I'll help you out. Appreciate you guys watching. Thanks.